Endurance athletes, such as long-distance runners, are particularly susceptible to bone stress injuries, better known as stress fractures. These injuries occur due to a combination of mechanical and metabolic events that are particularly prevalent in activities emphasizing leanness, high endurance, and high skeletal loading. Ken Kozloff's current research aims to clear up the uncertainty around our understanding of bone stress injuries.
A bone stress injury or bone stress fracture occurs sort of on this continuum of scale of a micro crack within the bone. So bone, just like any other sort of engineering materials, can sustain micro damage and micro fractures with repetitive loading. This is, you know, substantially more than just kind of, you know, going out or going for getting your 10,000 steps in.
Kozloff hopes to validate a series of markers that make an athlete more susceptible to bone stress injuries, including low energy availability, meaning not enough caloric intake to meet their needs throughout the day, having previous bone stress injuries, low body mass index, and low bone mineral density.
That's the overarching goal, is to catch things early so that we're not dealing with it, and to educate the student athletes on, hey, this is the list of primary risks that you actually have control over.
Female athletes may be particularly susceptible to bone stress injuries due to female athlete triad syndrome, which consists of three components: low energy availability, low bone mineral density, and hormonal dysfunction.
Having a delayed first instance of your first period puts you at higher risk for a stress fracture, as well as interruptions or irregularities in your menstrual status throughout the year.
We do a thorough physical, and I ask lots of history questions. Our physicians are very involved. Our dietitians are very involved at the initial point of contact.
Athletes are asked to fill out a sleep study to determine the quality of their sleep and how long they're sleeping. A blood draw is also done. The process is then repeated prior to the athlete's championship season to see how their sleep patterns and quality have changed, and a second blood draw is completed. Athletes also undergo a DEXA scan to assess their bone mineral density at two common sites, at the hip and at the lumbar spine.
This research can change the entire outlook an athlete has on an injury. Now we have some pretty solid evidence in relation to bone mineral density and where they fall. We have information on ferritin, we have information on biomechanics.
We've identified that sleep is a significant predictor of an athlete who may undergo a stress fracture. So we're very interested now in following this up with our blood biomarker data to try and validate and see if we can identify any trends that link our blood biomarker data with our sleep data and some of our other risk factors that we've been looking at. It's really been terrific working with the athletes, the medical staff, the training staff to really get at this problem, and we really couldn't have done it without buy-in and enthusiasm and eagerness from all of those parties. So this really is what makes the University of Michigan particularly outstanding place to perform this type of research.